السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي
سمعنا لي من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين فبشرى لصلي ويصلي وللعقدة بلسان يفقه قولي الحمد لله الذي أعيانا بعد أمامتنا وإليه النشور الحمد لله الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن أملا وهو العزيز الغفور الحمد لله all the praise all the thanks belongs to Allah رب العالمين the Lord of all the world we praise him we glorify him he alone deserves our worship and he alone deserves our praise may the peace and blessing of Allah be upon Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم brothers and sisters in Islam Brothers and sisters, in the only acceptable way of life, acceptable way Allah Azza wa Jal confirmed in the last and final testament, the glorious Quran, when Allah says in the Deen and the Islam that the religion in front of Allah, the way of life that is acceptable to Allah Azza wa Jal, it's no other way of life other than the Islam. So, brothers and sisters that are in that faith, I advise myself and yourself to fear Allah. I advise myself and yourself to be God conscious. I advise myself and yourself to protect our deen. May Allah make us continue to live as Muslims, die as Muslims, and resurrect us as believers, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Because it is important, my brothers and sisters, because Allah reminds us in the Quran when He said to us, Oh, you who believe, fear Allah as He ought to be feared. And do not die except in the state of Islam. This is a touching ayah. Very serious, pondering ayah. Oh, you who believe, Allah addressed believers. He addressed believers and He says we should fear Allah. Believers always fear Allah. But Allah is saying in this verse, oh, you believe, fear Allah as He ought to be feared. And at the end, give us a strong warning that's make sure you die in no other way except in the state of Islam. May Allah take our lives as believers, Ya Rabbal Alameen. May He direct our affairs to what pleases Him before He takes our life, Ya Rabbal Alameen. May He forgive us for our mistakes before He takes our life, Ya Rabbal Alameen. And for our brothers and sisters who have gone to the world beyond, who are believers, who are Muslims, we ask Allah to forgive them for their mistakes, widen their graves for them, and accept their good deeds. As to what follows, brothers and sisters, today's sermon is about time. With the limited time we have got, inshallah, if Allah permits, we'll discuss about time. What is time? How important is time? How are we making use of our time? We are time. Mankind, human beings are time. Yesterday, today, or tomorrow. Our very existence is time. But the thing that we don't respect is time either. We have so many time, and we've wasted those time. And if your time goes, brothers, Allah will not ask you about anything except the time you spend in this world. So time is of essence. Time is important. Most of the time, we ask Allah to give us long life. It means we want more time. But the time that is available, the time that Allah has given us, we haven't made use of it. We are not conscious of that time. We are not prioritizing that time. We are not utilizing that time to the best of our ability in order to have the best or the maximum reward. But we are yet asking for more time. May Allah grant us understanding. Allah has blessed us. First and foremost, for us to be a human being. He has created us. He has decided to make us human beings. He did not make us other class animals. If He had wanted, He would have made us a tree. But out of His divine justice and wisdom, He has chosen us as human beings. He has blessed us in this world. And the best of all, He guided us as Muslims. A way of life that is organized. A way of life that has a fixed principle. A way of life that has reference material. Point of reference. A reference point, the Quran and Sunnah. A way of life that is well guided, well organized. But what is left? It's left with us to follow that organization. It's upon us to accept the principles, the guidance that Allah has given us. So we need time. We've got time. Have we utilized the time? 24 hours a day. We use 8 hours to sleep. 6, 7, 8 hours to sleep. You use 8 hours to work. The rest of the time, what have you done with them? In the 24 hours, we are so misguided to the point that even the one that Allah asks us for, we have no time to give Him that time. We are busy in the dunya, brothers and sisters. We are chasing the dunya. Al-haqu mutakathir. Which will have been seeking worldly possession. We are in competition with one another in possessing materialistic tendencies, in achieving materialistic goals. We place our emphasis, we spend our resources, we spend our time in achieving something only for this dunya. And when death strikes us, and when death is about to strike us, there is nothing we've said for tomorrow. There's nothing. We haven't prepared ourselves. Because yet, we still think, yeah, we have time. We are pleading for time. And Allah is going to give us more time. But the worst of it, my brothers and sisters, is for brothers and sisters who are Muslims. Who have been asking for time. Allah has blessed them with time. Now they are 60, they are 55, they are 70. And yes, they are still asking for time. And they have not utilized the time that Allah has blessed them with. Ask yourself. Ask your age. How old are you? Just turn the clock back and ask yourself, how old are you? And ask, how much time have you spent to understand the laws, the rules and regulations of Allah? How many times, how much time have you committed in understanding your deen? How many times have you committed in doing ibadah? We should feel ashamed of ourselves. Allah grants us 24 hours a day. He has asked us to spend only 30 minutes or an hour maximum in doing our five daily prayers. Maximum. And yet still, we are doubling the prayers. And yet still, we have no time to pray. Yet still, we have no time to recite Quran. Yet still, we have no time in doing dhikr. But we can spend abundance of time in idle companies, in places that are not required for us, in places that we commit sin, brothers and sisters. And know that every second, every minute, every hour we spend, will be questioned about. So my advice is, before we ask for more time, let us concentrate on the limited time Allah has given us. Let us prioritize that time. Let us utilize that time so that we get the maximum reward. So we have the maximum reward. Spend quality time with your family. Spend 30 minutes or an hour with your family every day in reciting Quran, or going through the religious etiquette, guide them at that moment, 1 hour a day, that's a quality time. At least put aside a time that you say, this time is purely for Allah. Allah swear by time. Say, well, Asad, by the time, that man are in a state of loss. But with exception. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Except for those who believe and back it up with righteous actions. This is not a religion of lip service. It's a religion of talk and do. You make the pronouncement and you put it into action. This is a practical way of life. It's a way of life that practicalizes what is in the book. So there's no room for the fact, no room for hypocrisy, no room for making a statement that you don't believe in. Because if what you believe in, if it doesn't impact in your behavior and your character, then what you believe in is not important. Because Allah reminds us again in the Quran. Say, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, you believe. Lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. Why do you make statements? Why do you make utterances that you don't put into action? So Allah says, by the time man are in a state of loss, except those who believe and do good action, good work. As he says to Oscar Kalamata, wal hayata liyabluwakum ayyukum ahsanu amala. That is, he created death before life and placed us in this temporary world in order to test us, to see amongst us who will be righteous in their actions. Our actions are going to be rewarded according to our intention. In amal amal, in yet actions are rewarded according to our intentions. So in Islam, action is not enough, your intention is important as well. So it is a talk and do religion. It's a religion that practicalizes what is in their book. It is a religion that puts into practice what is in the Quran and Sunnah. So we hate to hear people saying, don't do as I do, just do as I say. That statement is a misplaced statement. It's like a medical doctor prescribing medication for sick patients, and the doctor is suffering from that, and the doctor refuses to take that medication. What a good is that medication? So we should stop saying, oh, don't follow me, don't follow what I do. Follow what I'm saying. That's hypocrisy. May Allah save us from that. The messenger has to respect the message for the message to be respected. But it doesn't mean that you know you don't see misguided messengers. You see them. Because Allah Himself told us in the Quran. Allah says, Atamuruna nasa bilbil. وَتَنْسَوْنَا أَنْفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْنُونَ الْكِتَابِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ So it's for you that want to follow people. Because of course you want to embark on what other people do that is wrong. Oh, he's a sheikh. Oh, he's an imam. Oh, he's just given this. Yes, this is a warning for you that you're not following them. Yeah, it is not ideal for the preacher, for the imam, for the sheikh to say something about Quran and Sunnah that he himself not doing it. It's not appropriate. But at the same time, you cannot justify it yourself. To say, oh, because he's not doing it, I'm not doing it. Allah reminds us, because all of us in front of Allah, we are equal, except in taqwa. All of us will be questioned. The ayah responsibility, the ayah you're questioning. So this is a clear verse that should put us to rest. To don't follow them, but follow the message. You are the one that advise. Atamruna nasa bil bil. You advise others to be righteous and avoid evil actions. Watansauna anfusakum, but you forget yourself. Wa antum taqtuluna al-kitab, and you are the one reciting the books. Afala taqiluna, are you senseless? So this is a clear indication to us. Because we are in the habit of justifying our evil actions by comparing ourselves to others. Oh, he's doing that. Oh, and he's the sheikh, and he's learned. That's no excuse for you, brothers and sisters. This verse has shown you that there's no excuse. If the message has reached you, if you've come across the message, then put it into action. Because the imam will be questioned. You will be questioned as well. Each and every one of us will be questioned on the day of judgment. So let us take care of our deen, brothers and sisters. Let's take care of the time that we've got. Maybe this will be our last day. So let's hasten in making repentance. Let's hasten in asking for forgiveness. And let's draw the line today. Maybe today is the last week. Maybe today will be a month to our death. But if we cross the line today and say, you know, from today, I want to perfect my deen. From today, I want to concentrate more in reciting the Quran. From today, I want to make sure I stop all evil actions that is under my control. And make sincere repentance. If Allah takes your life, inshallah, Allah will give you Jannah. May Allah grant us Jannah.
Amen.
Ask for forgiveness for myself and yourself. Allah is the most forgiving God in the Allah.
Amen.